Every year, thousands of nurses graduate and face the single most important test of their career, the NCLEX. This nationwide test is meant to determine one's ability to practice in a safe manner. Rather than consisting of knowledge-based questions, the NCLEX tests on application of critical thinking skills and nurse judgment. Being the only thing that stands in the way of a job, it is necessary that a newly graduated nurse pass this test. So the NCLEX-RN has this reputation for being this big and scary test because it is literally the test that will make you or break you. It determines if you can practice or not. And as of recently, on October 1st, 2020, they actually changed the test back to 75 questions. So you do get that experimental section that you don't know because it's integrated, but it doesn't count towards your final score. For this new and updated NCLEX, you now have a minimum of 75 questions and a maximum number of 145 questions with 5 hours to take the test. Previously, it was 6. The NCLEX has 4 major categories and 8 subcategories. All of the content on the test is integrated. It uses computerized adaptive testing to make sure that the questions aren't too hard or too easy for each test taker. To explain how the NCLEX works, there is this line, and basically all the minimum questions on the NCLEX will start below the baseline of difficulty. So if you were to get the question right, you go above the line, and if you were to get a question wrong, it drops and it could either be at the line or below the line. So at the end, when they tally up your score of how many questions you've gotten right or wrong, you could either be above this baseline or below the baseline. If you're above the baseline, then you pass the NCLEX, and the minimum number that the computer takes to calculate is 75 questions. The test does get harder and it does interact with you to see if you are doing well or not. So if you notice the test gets a little bit harder, know that probably you're succeeding because it is trying to challenge you as you go. By the way, you can find more information on this on the NCSBN website. They really go into detail over there about how the test is made, and any questions that you might have can get answered over there. So the first thing that I would do while studying for the NCLEX is to create a study schedule. You want to write down a schedule that you actually will stick to. Okay, let's face it. I am the biggest procrastinator ever, so I made sure to schedule times for me to procrastinate or times when I could hang out with my family and friends, and usually that would be on a Sunday. Otherwise, my weekdays, I would schedule either a section that I would study and be very specific about the section that I would study, or I would write in that I would take 2 75 question tests during that day and review those 2 tests as I go.
So this June study schedule is actually my mentor's. You can see that she scheduled her breaks for when she was moving out, and she also studied by system, so she wrote down which chapters and videos she would watch per day. In July, she condensed her schedule and didn't really write as many breaks, but I still recommend to go ahead and take breaks as to relieve your anxiety and just make sure that you feel renewed when you are studying.
At the bare minimum, you want to create a to-do list with 5 things that you're going to get done throughout the day so that you stay on point with your schedule. Personally, I studied for a little over a month and a half, and I studied kind of close to graduation so that all the information would be still fresh in my mind.
The next thing that I would do is to find somewhere quiet that mimics the look and feel of the test.
Okay, I know with COVID, this is actually really hard, so I'll find the next best place to study. Anywhere but my bed.
Normally, I would find myself studying in a library on a very quiet floor, but in order to adapt for COVID, I would recommend studying outside of your room, maybe in your family dining room if nobody is there.
I highly recommend changing into something that is less like PJs and something that you would definitely wear outside if you were studying in a library setting. Okay, so I almost forgot to tell you what softwares I actually used to study. So I ended up using a mix of Kaplan and UWorld. Kaplan was through my school. We actually had a boot camp for Kaplan 1 week after graduation, or a week after the week after graduation.
Kaplan's resource, while also having a full question bank and now computerized adaptive tests, is a lot more expensive than UWorld. I really enjoyed their breakdown of how to attack the question, but something I couldn't get over was that their questions felt harder than taking the actual NCLEX.
When you get a question, what you're gonna do is you're gonna read the question, and before you even look at the answer choices, you're gonna cover it up and try to answer the question on your own, or see at least what the question is trying to ask you and come up with your best guesses before you look at the answer choices. Once you come up with your best guesses, then you can go ahead and look at the answer choices and compare it to what you thought the answer was. This is just a way for you to like not really get swayed off topic and for you to really think about the answers before getting persuaded by the answer choices.
I liked UWorld because it's a test bank that mimics the NCLEX format on screen. They even timed their questions. When answering questions, you can turn on tutor mode so you can see the answers right after answering a question. You can also see your performance against other UWorld users and see the likelihood of you passing the test. It's very user-friendly and their explanations make way more sense than Kaplan did.
So there's no secret algorithm to passing the NCLEX. I would just rely on a good mix of studying, creating a study guide. You can Google study guides on Google or on Pinterest. I'll insert a picture over here of the one I used. This is my mentor, so unfortunately I can't share it in full. I also did a lot of QBank questions. I sat through and timed myself and did 75 question tests in an NCLEX-like environment, so in a library where it was super quiet and uncomfortable, and sat through it taking like one bathroom break if I really needed to. So as you're getting closer and closer to your test, you want to make sure that you're building the stamina you need to get through this potentially 5-hour test. It doesn't mean that you will take those 5 hours, but just in case you absolutely have to, you'll get through it without burning yourself out and still give it your all during that time.
To get ready for the test environment, I would clean off my desk, time myself as if I was taking an actual test, and plan for at least 1 or 2 bathroom breaks. I wouldn't get up until I was finished from taking this test, and then I would repeat that one more time for that specific day.
And just some last minute tips that I have for you guys. Definitely give yourself enough time to take your test. I only waited till 4 days before I started my new job taking the NCLEX, and so if I failed, I probably would not have a job right now. On the day before, make sure that you pamper yourself and relax. There's no more information that your anxious brain can absorb, so really just give yourself the day off, give yourself a pat on the back, and try to calm those nerves as much as possible. On the day of your actual test, make sure that you're not drinking coffee or a bunch of water beforehand, so you don't have to get up and go pee every 5 minutes, and make sure that you go and use the bathroom before you start your test. When you're done, that blue screen is not going to feel any better. You're going to feel like you failed and that you'll have to retake. Plan a celebration. I personally went to Vegas after I was done because I didn't want to sit at home and cry for 2 days until I got my test results posted. You can also try the Pearson View trick, but honestly, even though the trick worked for me, it didn't make me feel any better at all until my actual results posted. And lastly, if you don't pass in 75 questions and the screen doesn't turn blue, don't count yourself out. I didn't pass in 75 questions. It took me about 108 to pass, and I remember seeing my friend walk out of the testing center in passing in 75, and I got so scared that I wasn't gonna pass. I had to take a little moment and wipe away some tears. If you gave it your all, you shouldn't doubt that you tried your best to pass and that you'll probably see a pass. You just have to believe in yourself. So good luck. I hope that these tips really helped you out. Please go ahead and like this video and don't forget to subscribe. It really helps me out. And thanks so much, guys. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.